NFL pre-snap penalties.
Hey, if you've ever watched an NFL football game, or really any American football game, you've probably seen the officials call some penalties. You've probably seen the officials call a lot of penalties. Which means that at some point you probably asked yourself, wait, why was that a penalty? Or wait, how does that penalty work again? This video is the first in a two-part series about NFL penalties. In this video, we'll cover some basic information about what happens when a penalty is called, and then we will talk about the penalties that are called on things that happen before the ball is snapped or as the ball is being snapped. I'm not going to be covering every NFL penalty, but I'll be covering all of the ones that you're most likely to see, as well as a few of the less common penalties.
Basic overview.
Like in any sport, in American football, a penalty is called when a player or players violate one of the rules that govern the game. If an official has determined that a player has committed a penalty, the official will throw a yellow flag out onto the field. Unlike most sports, in many cases, when a penalty happens, the play is allowed to continue, after which the team that would benefit from the penalty is allowed to accept or decline the penalty based on what happened after the play was run. There are specific penalties where the officials will blow their whistle and stop the play as soon as the penalty occurs, and most of these are covered in this video. All penalties that are accepted result in the offense losing or gaining a certain number of yards. Most penalties have a set number of yards that the offense will gain or lose, but there are some that are spot fouls, so where the ball will be placed at the spot of the foul for the next play. All right, let's get into the penalties that are called on things that happen before the ball is snapped or as the ball is being snapped. The penalties that fall into this category are usually called pre-snap penalties. In order to understand these pre-snap penalties, there are two basic concepts you first have to know. The first is, before the play begins, there is a neutral zone that is defined as the length of the ball from tip to tip, from sideline to sideline. No player on either team is allowed to move into this neutral zone, except for one offensive player called a snapper, whose hand is allowed to be in there in order to put the ball into play. The second thing you need to know is that while there are no rules governing how defenses are allowed to move or line up on their side of the neutral zone, there is an extremely specific set of rules governing how the offense must line up and how and when offensive players are allowed to move before the ball is put into play. The first of these that you'll need to know is that at least 9 of the 11 players on offense must be set for a full second before the ball is snapped. So basically, they need to be frozen. The quarterback is allowed to move a bit, but the quarterback is not allowed to simulate the start of play. In addition to the quarterback, exactly 1 offensive player is allowed to be in motion. So they are allowed to move. But this motion must be parallel to the line of scrimmage or away from the line. So they can't get a running start or anything like that. And every other offensive player besides a quarterback must be set before this motion begins. With these rules in mind, let's take a look at the pre-snap penalties that you'll most commonly see called on the offense.
False start.
For the offense, the most common penalty that is called is the false start. This is when a player who is set for the play moves within that second before the ball is snapped. Referees will call a false start if an offensive player so much as flinches within that second, so this is a pretty common penalty. Usually there's only 1 offensive player that gets flagged for a false start. However, very rarely we get what I consider to be the holy grail of football penalties.
Ron Smile. Offense, everyone but the center. There you go.
You might assume that this means that the entire offensive line messed up, but the opposite is true. This usually happens when the quarterback signals for the ball to be snapped and everybody moves, but the center does not snap the ball, right? And so they are all false starting.
Illegal shift.
You might also see the referees call an illegal shift. This is where an offensive player never got set before the snap, or when a player never got set before their teammate went in motion. There's also illegal motion.
Illegal motion.
Which is where the player in motion moves toward the line of scrimmage. And they will call this if it's even like the slightest step towards the line of scrimmage.
Illegal formation.
Then there is the illegal formation. The offense will be flagged for an illegal formation if they are lined up in a way that violates the rules that govern how they are allowed to line up. The offense is required to have at least 7 players lined up on the line of scrimmage. And if you do the math, that means that at most 4 players can be lined up behind the line of scrimmage, and they must be at least 1 yard behind the line of scrimmage. Eligible receivers must be on both ends of the line, and all of the players on the line between them must be ineligible receivers, which means they're not allowed to catch passes, and it means that they're not allowed to be downfield when the ball is thrown. So this play here was flagged for illegal formation because we can see that only four of the linemen are actually within a yard of the line of scrimmage. This lineman here is a little bit too far back. Here's another play that was flagged for illegal formation, this time for an eligible receiver lined up in the wrong spot. The offense is here on the right, and we see that there are eight players on the line. This itself is not against the rules, but what you can't see from this angle is that this player here, who is on the interior of the offensive line, is eligible to receive passes. This player is a wide receiver, and when the ball is snapped and this player goes out for a pass, we see that this player was lined up improperly. So this was an illegal formation. What needed to happen was this player either needed to be a yard behind the line of scrimmage, or this teammate needed to be behind the line of scrimmage. Don't worry if you can't commit this all to memory right now. You're probably fine just knowing that an illegal formation penalty will be called when the offense is lined up improperly. Like all of these offensive pre-snap penalties, an illegal formation is a 5-yard penalty. All right, with all of this in mind, let's take a look at the offense on a play where no flag was thrown at the snap. So this is a play where everything went according to the book. All right, so the offense is on the right wearing white, and we see that there are 7 players on the line. It's kind of hard to see it from this angle, but these 2 wide receivers are a yard behind the line. So this is a perfectly fine formation in which there are 6 eligible players and 5 ineligible players, right? These 5 interior linemen are ineligible. Now, before the play begins, this player goes in motion. And this is perfectly fine because A, it's only one player in motion. B, the player is moving parallel to or away from the line. And C, none of the other players moved after the motion began. None of the players false start, and the ball is snapped and the play begins. All right, those are the pre-snap penalties that you'll most commonly see called on the offense. Let's take a look at the pre-snap penalties that you'll commonly see called on the defense. When the defense is flagged for a pre-snap penalty, it is almost always the result of a defensive player in the neutral zone as the ball is snapped. There are actually 3 different penalties that cover this situation depending on what happens, the most common of which is offside. Offside is kind of the generic penalty that they'll call on a player who is in the neutral zone at the time of the snap. Offside is a penalty that can technically be called on offense or defense, but it's exceptionally rare for it to be called on the offense, so you almost only see it on defense. Offside is most commonly called on a defensive player who has moved too soon into the neutral zone, but it could also be called on a player who is lined up in the neutral zone. When a defensive player is offside, the play is allowed to continue, and at the end of the play, the offense can choose to accept or decline the penalty. The exception to this is if the player who is offside has a clear path to the quarterback. In this situation, they will just blow the play dead because then it's a player safety issue. Then there's the neutral zone infraction. This is where a defensive player is offside and it causes the offense or someone on the offense to basically false start. And then there is encroachment, which is where a defensive player enters a neutral zone before the ball is snapped and makes physical contact with a player on the offense. Encroachment and neutral zone infractions are both dead ball fouls, so the referee will blow the whistle as soon as it happens. All of these penalties are 5-yard penalties. And finally, you might see the officials call a delay of game.
Delay game.
Delay of game can be called on the offense or the defense, but it's almost exclusively called on offenses who do not get the ball snapped before the play clock runs out. Delay of game is a 5-yard penalty.
Quiz time.
All right, that's it for the penalties that are covered in this video. Don't worry if you find yourself a little bit overwhelmed or struggling to remember some of the details that we just talked about. The NFL rulebook is very dense and very specific, and it takes time to commit all of the different penalties that you'll see to your working memory. A simplified summary of all of this would be to say the offense is not allowed to move before a play begins, with the exception of 2 players, and they have to be lined up in a specific way. The defense is allowed to line up pretty much however it wants, as long as no defensive player enters the neutral zone. If an offensive player moves before the ball is snapped, the play is blown dead, and that's either a false start, illegal motion, or an illegal shift. If the defense moves into the neutral zone before the ball is snapped, that's most commonly offside, but it might also be encroachment or a neutral zone infraction. I've been watching hours of penalty footage over the last week, and I can confirm that officials are a little bit loose in terms of which of these penalties they call for each situation. For example, if a defensive player is offside and the neutral zone infraction penalty might apply to the situation, the official might also call offside unimpeded to the quarterback. This isn't the biggest deal because these are all 5-yard penalties, and all of these penalties are really just different ways of looking at the same basic situations. Let's end this video with a little quiz. I'll show you 3 examples of plays that were flagged for penalties, and I'd like you to see if you can determine which penalty applies to each situation. If you said false start, you are correct because the player at the bottom of the offensive line moved before the ball was snapped. If you said neutral zone infraction, you are correct, because the player who was offside caused movement in the offense. So that's a neutral zone infraction. You probably knew this one was coming. We see the quarterback call for the ball, and we see the offense move as if the play is beginning, but the ball is not snapped. That means that this is, say it with me,
false start, offense, everybody but the center.
All right, I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. Be on the lookout for part 2, which should be coming in a few weeks. Unless this is the future, in which case it already exists and will be on your screen right now for you to click.